For what purpose does the gentleman from New York seek recognition?
Madam Chair, I have an amendment at the desk.
The clerk will report the amendment.
At the end of the bill, amendment offered by Mr. Engel of New York. At the end of the bill, before the short title, insert the following section. None of the funds made available by this act may be used to lease or purchase new light-duty vehicles for any executive fleet or for any agency's fleet inventory, except in accordance with Presidential Memorandum Federal Fleet Performance, dated May 24, 2011.
The gentleman from New York is recognized for 5 minutes.
Thank you, Madam Chair. On May 24, 2011, President Obama issued a memorandum on federal fleet performance that requires all new light-duty vehicles in the federal fleet to be alternate fuel vehicles, such as hybrid, electric, natural gas, or biofuel, by December 31, 2015. My amendment echoes the presidential memorandum by prohibiting funds in the Energy, Water, and Water Development and Related Agencies Appropriations Act of 2014 from being used to lease or purchase new light-duty vehicles, except in accord with the president's memorandum. Our transportation sector is by far the biggest reason we send $600 billion per year to hostile nations to pay for oil at ever-increasing costs. But America doesn't need to be dependent on foreign sources of oil for transportation fuel. Alternative technologies exist today that, when implemented broadly, will allow any alternative fuel to be used in America's automotive fleet. The federal government operates the largest fleet of light-duty vehicles in America. According to GSA, there are over 660,000 vehicles in the federal fleet, with over 14,000 being used by the Department of Veterans Affairs and other departments. By supporting a diverse array of vehicle technologies in our federal fleet, we will encourage development of domestic energy resources, including biomass, natural gas, agriculture waste, hydrogen, renewable electricity, methanol, and ethanol. When I was in Brazil, I saw how they diversified their fuel by greatly expanding their use of ethanol. When people drove to a gas station, they saw what a gallon of gasoline would cost and what an equivalent amount of ethanol would cost and could decide which was better for them. I want Americans to make the same choices. If they can do this in Brazil, we can do it here. We can educate people on using alternative fuels and let consumers decide what is best for them. Expanding the role these energy sources play in our transportation economy will help break the leverage over Americans held by foreign government-controlled oil companies and will increase our nation's domestic security and protect consumers from price spikes and shortages in the world oil markets. I have introduced a bill, along with the gentlewoman from Florida, that would also take a major step in this direction, and I think that this policy is something that we need to move. So I ask that everyone supports the Engel Amendment.
The gentleman yields back.
I yield back.